everybody, it's Anne from Anne's Stampin' Up. Welcome to another card making day here in Simcoe, Ontario. We are an independent Stampin' Up demonstrator. If you live in Canada and you don't have your own demonstrator, you can shop with me. You can reach me at stampsandtea@gmail.com or my demonstrator website is stampsandtea.stampinup.net. So today we're going to make a card using the, Christmas Friends stamps set. Christmas Friends is a little bear, a moose, a mouse and an owl, and that's going to be the main focus of the stamp set, but we're going to use a couple of other stamp sets as well, older stamp sets, not stamp sets but dies from older sets, just to add details to the card. So let me turn the camera down and we'll get started right away. There's a lot of parts to this card, but once you get all the parts, it's seconds to assemble. So I'm going to turn the camera down and we'll get started. So as I said, we've got lots of parts to this card today. We're going to use the bear from the Christmas Friends set. We're going to use a corner hexagon die from the Countryside Corners, and we're going to use a couple of circles from the Spotlight on Nature. So let's get started and I'll tell you what else we've got for supplies. We have basic garden green for your card base. That's 8.5 by 5.5, scored in 4.25. I've got a 5.25 by 4 piece for the inside. We've got a piece of real red, which is 5.25. We have a piece of DSP. Now this piece of DSP came from the Snowy Designs set. It's got lots of nice papers in there. It's the one with the snow globes in, you know, we've used it before. But this is the stripes we're going to use today for today's card. I've got I've got a piece of real red, which is 5 by 3.5, and another piece which is 4.5 by 3.5. I've got a piece, about a quarter sheet of cardstock of Whisper White for stamping on and cutting the bear out. I've got some markers. I've got real red, smoky slate and shaded spruce. So I think what we're going to do, I also have a 2 3/8 inch circle punch. So I think we're going to do the stamping first, and I'm going to use this quarter sheet of basic white cardstock to do my stamping on. I'm going to stamp on there and I'm going to use a couple of die cuts afterwards. So let's stamp the bear first, because that's the bigger part. And he's a lovely bear. Let's put this down here. There, and I'm going to stamp him up here. What else do I need to stamp on here? I need to stamp a sentiment. Oh, and I need the insert as well, the basic white for the insert. Okay, so I'll stamp that at the same time and then all the stamping's done. We've got some real red ink here, and I've got a sentiment for the inside which says, "Have a berry, Merry Christmas." Stamp it down here. Hope I can get it cut out nicely. And I've got a stamp for the inside which says Happy Holidays. There. So that's all the stamping done for this card. Let me just drop those in there. These out of the way. We'll do some colouring. We've got 3 alcohol markers here. We've got real red, smoky slate and shaded spruce. I'm going to colour the bear first of all. I'm going to colour the berries in real red because I don't want to miss the berries. I want to make sure I get them all, and I don't want to cover them up with green, you know. and the ball. Let's colour the ball. Just turn that around a little bit so I can see what I'm doing. Tiniest little bit of colouring on this card. Because really the bear doesn't need too much colouring himself, just maybe a little bit of shading. There's the red. Let's do the green next. I'll just colour in the wreath in green. And I just have to remember the two or three little portions, like around the bow, that you can see. And a little bit here. And then we'll just go around here. Going around the berries that are coloured in red first of all. And then all we're going to do is give him, this bear, a little bit of shading, just really where the marks are on the already stamped on the card itself. A bit of smoky slate, just for a bit of shading. And I'm really just wisping this colour up just around where the marks are that were, already stamped on the card. Wispy little strokes, not too heavy. Doesn't matter if I miss a little bit. And really, that's all he needs and all he's going to get. There we are. So that's coloured. Let's put the tops on these. Oops. There we go. So that's the colouring done. So now I've got to find some dyes. I need, oops, out of the polar bear set, I need the polar bear die, that's this one. And let me just get my plate for my stamp and cut and emboss machine, because I might as well just put these right on to the plate. So there's my polar bear. How does he look? Which way does he go? How about that way? There. I'm just going to tape him, tape it down, because I don't want it to move when I carry it across to the stamp and cut and emboss machine. There, out of the circles from the spotlight on nature, we're going to take this one here. Now, this is out of one set. This is number 4 die, if you will, and it's going to go down there. And then I need this die from the same set, and hopefully I can get it on there and get my Merry Christmas stamped out. If not, I could have stamped the Merry Christmas up there if I didn't fit it down there, but I think it will be okay down there. What do I have for tape? Do I have a, here's some tape. So I don't want this one to move. This one I'm just going to tape down carefully. There. There. If this doesn't work out, I think it will. I think it will. Let's think positive. I think it will. And then out of the Countryside Corners dies, I'm going to take the second largest die, and I'm going to put that on my piece of Real Red, which is the bigger piece of Real Red. The Real Red, which was 5.5 by 3.5, and that's just going to go on there, and that's going to there. And then I'm going to go to the Stampin' Cut and Emboss machine and cut all of this out. So I've got my circles, I've got my sentiment, I have my bear, and I have my hexagon shape. And I'll be right back. So here we are. Let's see what I've got. I have this really nice hexagon, that's lovely. I'm going to try and I'm just going to drop the dies back into a basket and sort the dies out later. There's the circle. Here's the smaller circle with my sentiment. And here's my bear. Go in there, that looks good. That's got some little pieces, but now it's good. So there we are. We've got all the parts ready. Now the other thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take my piece of Real Red, which was 3.5 by 4.5, I believe it was, and I've got this 2 3/8 circle punch, and I'm just going to punch a circle like that. That circle is going to go on the inside of this circle, so it just looks like a red circle with a nice white border around. Okay, so then we're going to start putting this card together. We've got basic green, which is 8.5 by 5.5. We've got a Real Red mat, which is 5.25 by 4, and we have a DSP mat, which is 5 by 3 3/4. So I'm just using my tape runner. Oops. I can get it the right way up. I'm trying to encourage the right way up. I've got about 1/8 of an inch all the way around. DSP mat. Oops. And tape. And again, about 1/4 of an inch all the way around. Which is going to go on here, and all of this is going down flat because it's quite a bit of bulk to this card, you know, so everything's going down flat, and I'm just putting that in the center. Oops. And there, then I have my circle with my nice border, and it's going to have a red circle inside. And it's just going to go right in the middle of the circle here. It fits nicely. There. The bear, we're going to pop him up on some dimensionals. Find some. There. Backs off these. Going to sit in the circle. Just like that. I should have glued the circle down before I put that on, but that's okay. Here's my circle, and he's just going about here. here, I think. That looks good. There. I've got some basic white ribbon. It's just called white, but it's got a lovely shimmery sparkle to it. It's Stampin' Up! Ribbon. It's about a half an inch wide. And I'm just going to take my handy dandy bow maker here. I'm going to cut off maybe, a good 8 inches, you know. This is my bow maker. Jim made it for me, piece of wood. It's about an inch and a half, maybe in between these holes. He drew a line down the centre, inch and a half, and then a hole every quarter inch. And the hole is based on the size of your doweling, of course. So I'm just going to quickly tie a bow here. Make sure my part is in the middle. Maybe should have had a little more ribbon, but that's okay. I'm just going to make it down. And it just slides off just like that. And there you've got a lovely little bow. Just need to pull that up a little bit. Trim the ends. Make sure the ends go the same way. I'm just going to put that up on a glue dot. Just to make sure I've got enough, because it's quite a large bow. That's just going to go down here. Maybe I've got the same length. This one looks a little bit longer. This is funny ribbon to cut. It doesn't cut very well. There we go. Make that do. This down here, like that, and then we've got this little sentiment here. A very Merry Christmas. He's just going to go down here. And then we've got these lovely little gems called iridescent faceted gems. They come in two sizes, not huge, but a bigger size and a smaller size. That's maybe just a quarter of an inch going across. But we're just going to finish this off with some gems. Oops. Large one. Small one, put a large one at the top just to fill in a bit of space. There, so there. Now, what have I missed? How about the insert? There you have it. One really, really lovely card. Now, I did see this card on Pinterest. I really do not know who made the original card, but it was on Pinterest, so I can't say it's my own design. If you'd like to copy and share this card, I'm sure it would be okay. You can copy mine. The one on Pinterest was a little bit different. It had a different circles and different DSP. So if you want to copy it, please do so. The only other thing I would do is I might take a little bit of Wink of Stella and just touch up the bow with a bit of Wink of Stella just to give it a little bit of sparkle. There. Just an extra little touch. So that's it. So there it is. That's today's card. Used all sorts of products, all which are listed in the video. There. That gets me out of that, repeating all that. Everything's listed in the video that you needed for this card. If you want to copy and share this card, please do so. If you sell your card, use the Stampin' Up! Angel stamp on, which just says all the supplies used are Stampin' Up! Supplies. And thanks for watching, everybody. We'll see you next week. Bye.